guy's been shot and killed out in front of Dunwoody Prep.
The motive is simple. He wanted his wife, he wanted his money, and he wanted to live his life. He wanted Andrea Sneiderman. He wanted to be with her. He wanted to marry her. He wanted Rusty Sneiderman's money. Rusty Sneiderman had everything that Hemi Newman wanted.
Did Andrea admit or deny an affair with her boss at that time after the murder?
Denied it.
Based on all the time you've known Andrea, based on your observations of her, her mannerisms, when she told you no, did you believe her?
No, but my heart really wanted to believe her.
But you didn't believe her. Thank you, ma'am.
Oh, yeah.
Find the defendant as to count one guilty beyond a reasonable doubt, but mentally ill.
It's more than about mental illness. It is about mental illness in the hands of a manipulator, of a calculating, very, very bad woman.
Do you have any idea why the defendant would have these feelings toward you? I don't want you to speculate. Do you know why he might have them?
I think I'm a pretty nice person.
She actually thought she could take the witness stand and maintain the position that she's maintained since Rusty's death, which is that there was no relationship with Hemi.
The gun, in this case, was in Hemi's hand. But the trigger, I respectfully suggest, was pulled by Andrea Sneiderman.
Ms. Sneiderman was placed under arrest earlier today and is currently being booked into the DeKalb County Jail. Outlined in that 19-page indictment are 8 counts that I, along with Chief Assistant Don Geary, are prepared to argue in a court of law.
Andrea Sneiderman is pleading to nothing. We expect that she will be exonerated at trial. She has every reason to believe she will be exonerated at trial, and she is going to come to court.